Long Shot was released on the 9th of May in the United States this year. It was directed by Jonathan Levine, who also directed All the Boys Love Mandy Lane, which is a really underrated horror movie. I mainly went to see it because of Seth Rogen, who is my favorite actor. Anyways, let's start with the movie. The movie started with Fred, a reporter, being in this group of Nazis and talking to them, probably for a story because he secretly recorded them. Then they wanted him to get a swastika tattoo because they all have one, so he got one but got stopped halfway too because they found out that he was a reporter and recorded the whole time. He was also ironically a Jew, so he fled and had to jump through the window from the second floor and landed on a car, and his face, which was absolutely hilarious. So great way to start the movie. Then it skipped to Charlotte, who is the US Secretary of State, who went to talk to the president, who was no other than Saul Goodman himself, or President Chambers in this movie, who said he would step down as the president because he wants to play in movies now, and he wants her to take his place. Then the movie skipped to Fred, who quit his job because the company he worked for got bought by Parker Rambley, a billionaire who Fred despises. So his best friend Lance tried to cheer him up and went with him to a party where Boys to Men played, which Fred loves. And when they arrived, Charlotte and the crew were also there, and Fred panicked and walked out and explained to Lance that he knew her because she was his babysitter when he was 13, which was an hilarious scene because they showed him laughing like Seth Rogen himself, which was a funny touch, and also him getting a boner because of Charlotte. So Fred and Charlotte talked a bit later, and they got interrupted by no other than Parker Rambley. So before Fred and Lance left, Fred confronted Rambley how worse of a human he was, and then wanted to walk away but tripped and fell the stairs down. The next day, Charlotte had to choose a reporter who would write for her, and she decided to take Fred. So he worked now for her, and was with her to all the trips around the world. So without going into detail, because the movie was pretty long, they fell in love when they were in a country who got bombed and nearly died. Now, and Charlotte wanted to smoke some drugs with Fred, because she was stressed after she had to talk to Rambley again, who wanted to destroy a lot of trees in order to build something there, I think it was something like that. Anyways, Charlotte obviously against it, so Fred and Charlotte went to this party and got high, but unfortunately they had to leave because there was a serious situation which was a hostage of them in another country, so she had to talk to the kidnapper high and was able to talk him out of it and rescue the hostage. That was also a really funny scene. And then there was also a scene at a party where she had to talk to everyone, so Fred couldn't really talk to her and had to witness her dancing with the Prime Minister of Canada, but at the end Fred took her to another room and danced with her. That was a really sweet and beautiful scene. Then we come to the end when Charlotte got called in the president's room where Rambley waits for her too, and they said she had to destroy the trees because if she didn't, Rambley would release a video of her boyfriend, which showed Fred masturbating to Charlotte's speech and coming on his own face. Yes, it really sounds as funny as it was. So he blackmailed her and she went with it. She told Fred about it, who was furious because he doesn't care if this video gets leaked, and she shouldn't either, but she didn't, she cared about her own image. Charlotte also said that Fred has to change himself when they are going to introduce themselves as a couple, so they had to fight and Charlotte left. Fred later told her that he was sorry and he would go with the plan so he could at least be with her. But she didn't call him back, so she went to this press conference and said that her younger self would be disappointed in her if she could see herself now. So they decided to tell the truth and said the president is an idiot and she wouldn't let him blackmail her. So Fred saw that and drove to her, but she was gone already. So Rambley leaked the video, so Fred went back to his apartment where Charlotte was waiting for her and told each other their love for each other, and went out where reporters and cameras waited for them, so Charlotte officially introduced Fred as her boyfriend and all cheered. Then movie skipped to the White House, Charlotte being President of the United States and Fred being the First Minister. So we showed a few portraits of the White House and also one of himself, which was hilarious because it was a ridiculous portrait of Fred made by Todd McFarlane, who made the Spawn comics. Then Fred showed his tattoo from the beginning of the movie, which he upgraded now, and the movie ended with Fred and Charlotte sitting on the couch. And yes, that was the movie in a nutshell. Let's move on to the actors. Seth Rogen, being my favorite actor ever, was obviously amazing. Great performance by him as expected, I just love him. He also liked my tweet. Then Charlize Theron, being just as good, wow, her acting high was amazing. She crushed this role. O'Shea Jackson Jr. was great as well. And June Diane Raphael and Ravi Patel were great too. Alexander Skarsgård was hilarious too. Andy Serkis was amazing as always. Bob Odenkirk was great too. And fun fact, Wendell Park, Lily Yachty and Mandy Orton were all in the movies, which were nice cameos. So with all this being said, this movie was amazing, not just funny but also beautiful. I recommend it to everyone out there. If you haven't seen this movie, go see it now. I'm giving this movie a 9 out of 10, So let me know if you saw it and if you agree with me, or if you are still planning to see the movie, or if you don't care about it at all. And yeah, that was my review for Longshot. The next movie I'm going to watch is John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum, which I'm definitely excited for, which you would know if you watch this video, link in the description. I don't know when I'm going to watch it, so stay tuned for my review, and yeah, that was it. Roll the outro. We could be more than just part-time lovers.